Now to a really fun story. One man will become the most powerful in the world. The other does whatever a spider can. If you think that sounds like the making of a new superhero comic book, well, you're right. KCRA 3 photojournalist Sam Gonzalez gets reaction from people buying the hottest Spider-Man comic book, and it features President-elect Barack Obama.
There it is.
Five of these were already spoken for.
I think it's so popular because Barack's so popular, honestly. A lot of people like him, and everybody loves Amazing Spider-Man.
That's it. All done.
Yeah, I actually read where Stan Lee was talking about why he did this. I'll probably have to come back and get a second print.
Stan Lee was saying why he decided to put Obama in the comic book, so that piqued my interest even more, and so I came by just to see if I could see it. And ended up buying one. I guess I was one of the lucky ones.
It's extremely hard. Basically, the only reason they released the second printing so soon was because there was such a great response to the first printing. They knew that it wasn't going to satisfy people's needs.
Of course, it's because of Obama. history. It's history in the making.
Obama's such a serious person. I think it's pretty great that he's on a comic book.
It's absolutely historical, you know? I mean, it's the first African-American president, and he's on one of the biggest comic books that people read, you know? So it's huge.
So this particular Spider-Man comic spins a story in which the imaginary superhero thwarts a plot to disrupt Obama's inauguration. Now, it sells in the stores for $3.99, but right now on eBay, people are listing it for $50. So we'll see.
I wonder what his daughters think. I wonder if they're embarrassed by it or if they think it's
probably,
cool.
You know, at that age, probably really impressed.